Another dirty, sexually graphic day in the Jody Arias courtroom, this time with very steamy, filthy, really, X-rated texts from Travis to Jody read in open court. Do these texts prove Travis abused Jody and drove her to kill him in self-defense? Well, the defense showed explicit triple X-rated text messages that Travis sent to Jody. We got to warn you, this is graphic, but it was said in open court, and it's central to the defense claim that Jody was sexually degraded and abused by Travis. Listen to this.
The progressiveness of it from the very clean to the very dirty and everything in between.
You are the ultimate slut in bed.
You'll rejoice in being a whore. That sole purpose in life is to be mine, to have animal sex with, and to please me in any way I desire.
Jody also testified about a huge fight she had with Travis where she threatens to tell the whole world he's a pedophile. Listen to this.
He said, I'm going to tell all your friends and family basically about all the, I can't remember how he characterized it, but I think it was something like psycho things that you've done. He's waking me up in the middle of the night with a whole bunch of text messages. They're all unkind. He's threatening me. I just felt like he was being a complete bully at that point, and I was tired of being bullied. I think I just got fed up, and I called up and I said,
what'd you say?
It was really mean. I said, the only thing I'm going to be spitting out is the fact that you're a pedophile with a past.
Straight out to our own senior producer, Celine Darkelstanian. You were in court today while all of these incredibly, I would say, filthy. I mean, it's beyond just sexually graphic. This is filthy, dirty stuff, these text messages. Tell us, what was it like there with her family, his family, and we're hearing these texts from purportedly Travis Alexander.
Yeah, today the defense was definitely painting a not-so-nice picture of Travis by showing his text messages that were extremely dirty, like you said, to Jody. There wasn't much reaction from his side of the family, and that's only because, remember, the judge has told his family, specifically his side of the courtroom, that do not react. If you have any type of an emotional response to anything, please get up and leave the courtroom. So I think they're very aware to keep everything in and not let everything show so that they don't get kicked out of the courtroom during this trial. But I have to say that today we noticed it being very heated between the two sides, the defense and the prosecution. At one point, the prosecution was objecting to something that Jody said, and Jody quickly said, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. And the defense turned around and said, don't worry, Jody, you don't have to say I'm sorry to him. So you could tell it's getting really heated in the courtroom between the two sides, the two attorneys.
This is what happens when there's so much at stake. The defense carefully crafting an image of Jody as a beaten and degraded and abused woman. Listen to how Jody explains how she would shake in fear of Travis.
Did this shaking, did that begin before or after the beatings began? Did this begin before he slapped you in the face or in the cheek?
It was kind of like the jaw, neck area.
Okay.
Yes, it began in the fall 2007.
Before he threw you down and choked you?
Before he choked me, yes.
Before he broke your finger and kicked you in the ribs?
Yes.